So this is a diac construction and symbol. What is diac? Diac is called as DI refers to diode and AC is the alternating current. If you can see diac here, you can see A1 and A2. Here also A1 and A2. This is construction, this is symbol. So diac is nothing but two diodes in parallel, connected in parallel with anode terminals on either of the ends. This is also a semiconductor device where PNP, just like NPN and PNP transistor, diac has a PNP layers with N1 and N3 layers at the top and the bottom. So 5 layers in diac with A1 and A2. This A1 and A2 can be called as MT1 and MT2. MT1 is the main terminal 1 and MT2 is the main terminal 2. So we can call it either A1 and A2 or MT1 and MT2. This is a symbol for diac, diode alternating current. Next, moving on to the working. What happens in the working of the diac? So before going to the working of the diac, let's understand what happens when diac is forward biased and what happens in forward biased in both A1 and A2. It will be forward biased in both A1 and A2 separately. So listen, A1 is forward biased, positive is connected to A1, so it is called as forward biased with respect to A2. If you connect MT1 and A1 to positive terminal, eventually this will be connected to negative terminal. So two cases, A1 will be forward biased with respect to A2 and A2 will be forward biased with respect to A1. If A1 is forward biased, see the flow of current P1, N2, P2 and N3. So main objective of any semiconductor device you are seeing or you are going to see is that it should conduct the current, and it will conduct the current when certain amount of voltage is applied. That voltage may be threshold voltage, breakdown voltage, cut-in voltage or break-in voltage. So current flow in this direction when A1 is forward biased, P1, N2, P2 and N3. Similarly, if A2 or MT2 is forward biased, see here P2, N2, P1 and N1. This is the direction of flow of current when A2 is forward biased with respect to A1. So when coming to working characteristics, so this is forward bias characteristics and this is reverse bias characteristics, or this can be called as positive half cycle and this can be called as negative half cycle. So when I say it is a positive or negative half cycle, don't consider it as something like AC. So it is called as a positive and negative half cycle because when forward bias voltage is applied, this will be the curve, and when reverse bias voltage is applied, when and this will be the curve. Okay, so one more thing is I told when A1 is forward biased, the conduction will be P1, N2, P2 and N3, and A2 is forward biased, the conduction will be P2, N2, P1 and N1. So when A1 is forward biased, direction of the current is in downwards. When A2 is forward biased, direction of the current is in upwards. So don't take downwards and upwards standard notation. Based on the orientation of the diagram in the slide, I am saying it as downwards and upwards. So this diac is called as bidirectional device, a device which conducts bidirectional current in the both direction. This is very important. And one more thing about diac is diac has a equal doping, just like for all the layers, just like NPN PNP transistor. Diac does not have more amount of doping in one region and less amount of doping in another region. In NPN transistors or PNP transistor, emitter will be moderately doped, base will be lightly doped and collector will be heavily doped. So that's not the case in diac. All the layers are equally doped. And one more thing is, here you can see PNP layer in diac and N1 and N3 here. There are diacs which has NPN and PNP3. So this NPN and PNP may remember you the transistor. Yes, this is a pattern of transistor but not a transistor. Transistor has one difference between diac and this transistor. This transistor has a base terminal, emitter and collector terminal. The one important thing is the diac does not have the base terminal, whereas the transistor has a base terminal. Diac has only two terminals, A1 and A2. So when moving on to the characteristics, we see this. When voltage is applied here, there will be some small amount of, where I am pointing, a small amount of increase in current. This increase in current is called as leakage current. When voltage polarity is applied, there will be some amount of charge, minority charge carriers in the depletion region, some amount of positive and negative holes and electrons carriers in depletion region, which recombines and produces some amount of leakage current. So this is the influence when small amount of voltage is applied. So now the voltage is going to increased, and further when it reached some 30 to 40 volt, what happens, there is this point called as breakover voltage of diode, after which the diode originally starts conducting. This is the point where diode remains in off state. This region diode does not conduct. Any semiconductor device, when will we say it is conducting? When the current flowing through the device starts increasing, then only we say that the diode or diode or whatever is conducting. Here, just because when voltage is increased and a curve is obtained, it does mean it is conduct. We have to make the device conduct. So this point is called as a breakover voltage, or this region is called as what, negative dynamic resistance region or negative resistance region. What is simply a negative resistance region? When voltage is increased, there is no more voltage drop across the diode, but the current starts increasing. Here if you can see, here when voltage is increased, it starts increasing up to 30 volt. Here still when the voltage is also increased, it is a point which is breakover point, breakover voltage and breakover current. And this is a negative resistance region, where when the voltage is try to increase further, it is increased, but the current only increases, voltage decreases. Voltage decreases, this is a point where when voltage decreases and the current increases. Again, here voltage, it means from this point to this point, diode accepts the voltage drop fully. 0 to 30 volt, the diode accepts the voltage drop fully. After a point where breakover voltage, diode does not accept the voltage drop, and voltage drop starts to decrease, but the current starts to increase from lower end to the higher end. So this characteristics, this region is called as negative resistance region, where there is a less voltage drop and a very high increase in current. So this is applied in the reverse characteristics also, reverse bias also. When voltage starts increasing, this is the region where voltage gets fully dropped, 0 to 30 volt, and this is called as breakover voltage, and this current is called as breakover current. After breakover current, if the voltage is increased, the current also starts to fully increase and reach this spike. So this is all about working of diode. One more point I would like to say here is, we saw about leakage current when voltage polarity immediately is applied. When we want to start the process, we get leakage current. Similarly, there is called as holding current in a diode. This holding current is the current above which the diode remains in the conduction state. The current is conducted through the device, below which the diode does not conduct. It remains in non-conducting state. So this is off state. This is the state where the diode fully moves and reaches a spike. This is a conducting state. So this is all about the construction, symbol and working of diode.